Rated M for mature.
No, my mind is as empty as a beggar's purse.
You want to talk?
Of course. What do you want to know?
I should probably.
Okay. What's next? Yes, my friend. I am all ears. My brother and I were adopted by a couple of retired assassins. I guess the orphanage did not do a family background check. Mine was perhaps a little more unconventional than most, but I suppose all childhoods are interesting to some degree. My parents provided me with a love and encouragement. Apart from the nightly training sessions, we were a normal family. I was bullied by the other Khajiit children because of my unusual color and markings. My mother showed me a handy trick with a rock and a glove. I was never bothered again. Childhood is extreme. It is a time of hard learning, but also teaching. Anyway, I never seriously hurt anyone until I was a lot older. If you need anything else, just ask.
Hey, love. I'm just thinking about how much I like you. I've noticed that many people I don't get it. What? All that firewood you're carrying must be heavy. Or maybe it's just the weight of your guilt on your shoulders. Of course. If you want to get in my breeches, you need only ask, you know? Okay. Here I am. How can I help?
So good to see you. Yes, I have, and I'm afraid the situation is not good. The crystal is a fragment from something called the Dream Crystal. It is, I fear, a Daedric artifact. It can be used by the holder to create an alternate world of limited scale in the Plains of Oblivion, wherein the user may create anything they could possibly dream of. The crystal was discovered long ago and shattered into 5 pieces. Onto these 5 pieces was placed an incantation, sealing the dark magic within and preventing their use. It would appear that somehow Vernon has found the crystal shards. He sent 4 of them off to be studied by his pupils, the lowly necromancers that plague the land. However, it appears when we threw him out that he did not have time to reacquire this one, though we caught him sneaking around here, so he tried. Well, the fact that his necromancers have the shards is very bad. The incantation most likely wore down over the years, and they may be trying to, or have already succeeded at, breaking it completely. So, we need to get those fragments from them. The problem is that I haven't a clue where they might be, and there is no way to track them. That's why I was hoping you, the Traveler, could search for them. Keep an eye out, and if you acquire them during your travels, bring them to me. Any place with necromancers may have one of the shards. If you find such a place, search it, or ask around the nearby settlements. The crystals probably move around as the necromancers try various things on them. Return once you have gathered all 4 shards, and we will decide how to proceed. I'll be waiting here. See ya.
that noise?
Time to die. Living on an entirely new planet. It'd be difficult. With these blocking. So, if I run down.
Target vectors.
If someone's bothering you, point me at them, and I'll teach them to disrespect you with my fangs.
You want to ask me something? No, nothing at the moment.
Here I am. I'm not entirely sure this is the best spot for a chit-chat. Ifrei's blessings. So attentive, aren't you?
I am getting used to this now. The sharp rocks, the deadly traps, the stale air. It's not so bad.
Thank you. to sow. We hear the chickens. Isla saw them.
Can I? Yes? Oh, let me see it. Yes. Yes, this is it. Thank you so much. Please, have this. You have certainly earned it. You know what? He would want this hammer to see some action. You look capable of handling such a mighty weapon. I want you to have it. Use it on some bandits. Keep this land safe with it. That's what my father would have wanted.
Hello? I'm here for you.
See for yourself. Have a nice day.
Hello. Good boy, Isolde.
a live one over here.
You're going to try to kill me.
Great sword. It ruined the meat. Are you a hunter? If not, you should try it. Tracking your prey, outsmarting them, closing in, then bah! Dinner! Oh, it's great. We hunt for our food, gather water from the creeks and pond, we even spend some time smithing weapons and armor. Not that we're anywhere near as good as Rengar, but we've made a couple things in our time. We also visit town every once in a while. If you haven't yet, you must go down to the Amber Mead Inn and try their Amber Mead. Oh, the best mead I've ever had, I tell you. Our whole lives. We were born and raised here, as were our parents before us, and their parents before them. Our great-grandparents were the last ones to be raised at Hjorgannar Manor. I can't imagine how different their lives were from ours. In the war 100 years ago, an Unvaldr raiding party sacked it, destroying much of what our family owned. They rebuilt most of it, but then they decided it was no good. They moved out here and built this cabin. Our family has lived here since. We've certainly tried, but neither of us managed to find someone yet. Ulgar was sweet on a girl once, but then she turned out to be a bandit kingpin and he had to kill her. He's a light-hearted guy. He got over it. Plus, collapsing an entire bandit warband from the inside was great fun for him. I've had my share of fancies, but I haven't found the right one yet. Do not worry for us. Hjorgenar blood is strong. It will live on. As it was with you, my friend. See you.
Greetings, friend. Safe travels.
You're the one who came through the gate, aren't you?
Thank you. Leave now, or you'll regret it.
Have come here.
I knew it.
You're the one who came through the gate, aren't you?
got trouble.
Here we go again.
I have your back, my friend.
Do you need some?
I'm getting out of here.
Hello, traveler.
Ah, you're looking for Svea. Honestly, I think the Frost Runner's wreck is just off the coast by the ice caves. But I'm not certain. Well, I didn't trust him. He sounds like a good-for-nothing treasure hunter, and like he made up that story about his family. That ring belongs to Svea. The coast may look docile and beautiful, but it's just as deadly as the rest of Falskar. We don't have much lore from before our arrival. But what we do have refers to this place as the Dread Coast. It used to shield the land from the Arctic winds, and was one of the most dangerous places on the entire island. The shoreline is littered with sunken reminders of the treachery that lies behind those calm waves. It's so bad that I'm the only one who still runs a boat to Skyrim, at least officially. The shores also serve as an inlet for swarms of bandits and hired blades, ready to pillage the land and take all that we have left. But I'm probably just making it sound worse than it is. We get by. It isn't always easy, but we make do. Well, actually, no. I'm not alright. I recently found something that's brought up a lot of questions about some old friends. Two friends of my parents. They ran the lighthouse a long time ago. Janna and Avar were friends of my parents when my mother was pregnant with me. A long time ago. They lived in the lighthouse and kept it running, guiding boats in during storms or dark nights. One day, out of nowhere, they left on a trip to Skyrim. A few days later, they were supposed to return, by boat, of course. That night, there was a particularly nasty storm, and they never made it home. After they weren't heard from for several days, a guardsman went up to check on them, to see if they were alright. He was never seen or heard from again. And so rumors arose about that place being haunted. As far as I know, nobody has stepped foot in that place since that guard, and that was damn near 50 years ago. Well, it was all ghost tales and bedtime stories, until recently. I was walking on the beach the other day, clearing my head before running a shipment to Skyrim, and I found something. In a small dugout on the beach, was a sack of old coins and a letter. These coins, they're really old, must have been on that beach for ages. And the letter was from my parents. I think it belonged to Jaina. Why would they hide something like this on the beach? What happened to them?
Living on
now I really want to find out.
It can sometimes be difficult with these blocky teeth. So I filed mine down to be shelved.
Oh, I couldn't possibly ask you to do that. Nobody knows what's in there. It could be dangerous. I guess if you really want to, I can't stop you. Just be careful, and let me know if you find out what happened to them. Oi there, name's Wolf. I'm the captain of the ship docked here. I wanted to thank you for helping out. Damned bandits snuck up on us. Now, I also wanted to offer to you the service of my boat. If you need to travel between Falskar and Skyrim, as long as I'm in port, I'll take you. However, it won't be free. I wish it could be, but travel simply costs too much these days. It'll be 500 gold a trip. I know it's a bit steep, but I'll shift my schedule for your convenience. Hopefully that's alright. It's the best I can offer. The trip takes less than a day. Just hop on the boat whenever you need to go and I'll get things in order. You can even have the top bunk.
Thank you for what you did. We are getting ready to make a move. I couldn't let them do anything to Freya or Galen. Please, accept this. It's the least I can do. Please, accept this. It's the least I can do.
Actually, yes. Yes, I do. They were staying in the Hjalma Armory, just northwest of here.
Get a good price.
You're looking for them, aren't you? Here, let me mark it on your map for you. If you need something, I've probably got it around here somewhere. Money put into the Water's Edge trader would be money well spent. I could increase my stock and try to survive with fewer customers.
Good for nothing.
By the Nine, thank you. Maybe we'll make it just a bit longer out here. You've done a great thing today, friend.
All right, if you insist. It's mostly covered in ruins and hollow reminders of this land's dark past. There's the old lighthouse, supposedly haunted, Dragonbone Perch from the time of the dragons, and Grimrot Grotto, where pirates used to berth. Until the mountain shifted and it collapsed, sinking the fort above and trapping the men inside. They say the crew still roams the caverns inside. And last, there's the ruins of Holmer, an ancient Nordic fishing village. Gods know how they survived living on the coast like that. A long time now, we got married almost 10 years ago, and had Galen shortly afterwards. Our anniversary is coming up soon. I do need some help getting Freya's gift. I don't suppose you'd be willing to give me a hand, would you? Good. You look like the kind of person who may enjoy what this entails. I want to get Freya something special for our 10th year together. Her mother used to always wear a brilliant sapphire necklace, a gift from her father. She wore it all the time. When we were just kids, her parents were killed by highwaymen. Her mother must have hidden the necklace because the bandits didn't take it. A guard gave Freya the necklace and she kept it close. However, the bandits must have figured out she had it, because they broke in a few days later and stole it from her. It was all Freya had left of her parents, and it never was recovered. I want to give Freya some of those memories back and make a replica of that necklace. It won't be the real thing, but I think it will mean just as much to her. Rengar of Amber Creek is capable of crafting such a fine piece. However, he'll need a very special gem to do so. I need you to go to Grimrot Grotto and recover a priceless sapphire, then take it to Rengar. He can then remake the necklace, and I can surprise Freya with it. The tricky part is that the gem is believed to be guarded by the crew of the sunken ship that once carried it. They still walk the cave, but they aren't living anymore, if you understand what I mean. If you do all this and get me the necklace, I'd be forever in your debt. The grotto is down the coast, far to the west. Safe travel. Yes?
Speak to me. I'm wondering how much gold this place makes a year. I'm hoping you get a good deal in here. I'm thinking you should sell off anything we do not need. I'm thinking you should do the talking here. I would just waste our gold on pretty rubbish. Let us go.